Hey guys, Frank here, and welcome back to... No, welcome to Scary Nights at CBTV Survive, the end chapter. Now, for the previous two games, it seems like the games are bugged. So, once again, just like with the third game, the fourth game, there was a character that just wouldn't work, and the game just... Maybe I was doing something wrong, but if you guys know, let me know in either this video or the previous video what I was doing wrong, because for night 3 in the 4th game, the green animatronic kept killing me no matter what I did, and I have no idea what I have to do about them. But anyway, let's get into this game. Oh, Nightmares of BTP, if you hear this laugh, you need to find him in the window and close the window before he kills you. Close the window to make him leave. Okay. Alright. If you see the warning icon coming to you, close the door, hide the closet, flashlight. Remember to understand the mechanics, good luck beating the game. What is this? How do I open it back up? You can explore the rooms. Oh god. Oh, this is convoluted. Oh no. I have to remember this stuff? Vent? Oh no. This is so complicated. What the hell? This is so complicated. So it seems like for the first night, you just have to stay in the first room, which I'll do. I'll do this time. Alright. I'm gonna have to get really used to this. Holy crap. This is obviously giving Five Nights at Freddy's 4 vibes. So we can go this room, look backwards, got this room. So we can go into the kitchen room here. But for some reason the back button sends you the long way. Because this is the closet, alright. So this is the closet, alright. So to check the windows. When I hear a laugh. Alright. So there we go, so we only have to deal with him for this night. So we can even preemptively close the windows. So that's interesting. So what's this? What's this arrow? Is that an exit? Wait, that more windows? Is this more windows I have to look at? Bathroom? What the hell? And I'm probably gonna have to start moving quickly in these later nights. I didn't see him. Okay, so we can be at either windows. I'm guessing that is crazy. It also doesn't give you much time to get rid of him either. Which is crazy. Okay, how are you meant to play this game? This is crazy. So it seems like this game's running into the issue of the previous games, which is that the amount of time it gives you is very unforgiving. Which is a little issue, but... Oh well. I guess we just gotta keep trialing and erroring. Is it because I put up one of the pieces in that room that he spawned there? Is that what it's dependent on? So what's the best room for me to sit at then? Just in case. Or is it just gonna rely on me being quicker in my action? Apparently Sebi was there. I didn't hear him, but alright. I guess. Shit. This is as confusing as Push Shift 2. So it says if you see the warning icon, close window, hide closet, flashlight. So the flashlight goes down very quickly. Oh, it also recharges very quickly, to be fair. This is really confusing. Oh shit. See what I mean? That time he was at the other window, I couldn't do anything about it. Oh my god. So he can spawn in that window, he can spawn in that window. Oh my god. And they expect you to know, to deal with that. How? How do you deal with it? His jump scare timing is very unforgiving and all that. It's crazy. So you can go to this direction with these windows. Wait, how do we go to this room? Doesn't seem like we get... There's windows here too! So you can only choose either two there. Oh, you can only choose. So you can go to multiple windows. There's five windows you can go to. How am I supposed to know which one? It's crazy. There's no way of beating this. There can't be. There's just no way. The amount of time it gives you to try and close the door is impossible. It's legitimately not possible. What were they thinking when creating this game? Oh yeah, let's just make this game impossible. Let's make it so nobody can beat this game. That sounds beautiful. Let's make this game impossible. Yeah, that sounds good. Let's make it so they can't deal with the threats at all. And then spread them out so that they have to check constantly. Crazy. The fact is only night one. Keep that in mind. And we got a vent system here. It's crazy. I just don't know what to say. Is there any windows in here? Okay, good, there's not. Oh, we're in this room. What is this? Okay, we found him. We got lucky. I still died. I closed the window on him and still died. I'm so confused. If you hear his laugh, you need to find him in the window and close the window before he kills you. I did that. Close the window to make him leave. I did that. I closed the window. Is the warning, am I supposed to read that? Is that telling me something I'm missing? I'm so confused. If you see the warning icon coming to you, close the door, hide the closet, flashlight. Remember to understand the mechanics of the game. Good luck being the game. What do you mean? None of this makes sense. None of it. It makes no sense. What does this arrow mean? Am I supposed to leave the area too? There's no way anyone's beat this game. There's no way. That is not possible. Okay, I saw the warning icon and I hid. Are we good? Seems like it. Also seems like we didn't die there. Oh, so the exclamation mark sometimes appears as well, and I have to move away if that happens. Okay. Interesting. Maybe that was what I was missing the entire time. Maybe the game isn't unforgiving. Okay, maybe I'm lying. Oh shit. Oh my god. That was a good attempt. Maybe I'm supposed to be looking out for the exclamation mark to know they're in that room. I don't know. We'll have to keep experimenting. So I have to close the windows and then leave the room. Alright, I think by close the door it means leave the room. I think that's what it's meant to say. So maybe it does take its time. I don't know. Got vents still, which I don't understand the purpose of. Alright. I'm gonna at least be night one of this game because, I mean, may as well. It seems possible to do as well, so I'll do so before I end this game series. Got rid of them. There we go. Seems like the... Oh no, that's not a closet. What am I talking about? But it seems like the exclamation mark signifies the room they're at very much. So as long as I find that, that's also a really good thing. Alright, well, hopefully we're able to beat this night, because adding any other animatronic will make this 10 times more difficult. and I just wouldn't be able to keep up. At least I don't think it. I could. But yeah, it seems like it doesn't mean close the door, it means leave the room. And the thing is just a bit wrong. Maybe he starts here, I don't know. Maybe that's what this arrow is showing, is that they start here. But then why were they going here? I don't know. Maybe they go closest to the area you've spent the most time at. I don't know. Since the last cycle. I'm not too sure. We'll still have to experiment with this night, because it's really confusing. We're gonna really try to understand this, alright? It's gonna happen again. That was different. And I died. So does that mean if there's no warning icon, I stay there? Maybe. I'm not too sure. Because I definitely closed that on him. He was definitely at the window. Or was there a distraction one as well? And that wasn't the real one. I'm not too sure. We're just gonna have to keep experimenting with this game once again, because I really, really do not know. I just don't know. We're gonna keep listening out for the sound cue. See, like for that time, we have to go away because the exclamation mark was there. But then what I'm guessing is if it doesn't appear, we just stay in the room. Maybe that was the difference between the last one. Because that's the only difference I noticed with me dying. I also noticed the difference of the position of the character as well. They didn't have their face at the window. All we could see was their body, which is a bit different. But yeah, it's confusing. Oh no, I did it again. I accidentally opened the window. That's also something I noticed. So it seems like when I went backwards that one time, I accidentally opened the window. Maybe that's a different character way after hiding in the closet. I don't know. This game is so confusing. This is so confusing. Maybe they weren't actually there yet. Don't know. I'm really trying to guess this. This weird ass game. But truly, this fan game really seems like it could have been really good. Though it seems like the gameplay is too complex. Same issue as Post Shift 2. Seems a bit too complex. See, if I do this, I'm dead. So, if I close the window, stay in the room, I'm dead. When there's no exclamation mark. If I close the window and exit the room, I'm dead. So clearly for that character, I have to do something different. Maybe I have to shine the light on them. Maybe I have to hide in the closet. I don't know, but we'll have to figure it out. But that doesn't make sense because it's still the same character. There is only one character after us. So it doesn't make sense. So I don't know what to say. I really don't. I just don't know. It's crazy. See, this time, it's the same. The symbol showed, and is faced with close up. So what do I have to do different when he's away from the window? Do I have to, maybe I don't close the window? I don't know. I really have to figure this out. Eventually. This is crazy. See, didn't work. The flashlight doesn't work. Does that mean I have to close the opposite window? I'm so confused. I feel like, I don't know why, it just feels like there's a part of the programming missing. Like, it feels like with that pose, there's like a bit of the code missing. For that pose, where it would register, oh, have they done this action? If so, move away. If not, jump scare. I feel like it's missed some of that coding where all it can think of is jump scare. I don't know. It just feels like there's a missing code because, I mean, I'm doing the right thing and I'm still dying. I don't know what happened, but I survived. We got rid of him. Alright. Truly, this would be the biggest bounty of all time. Night one of... Oh, Scary Nights at Sebi TV's 5. I just don't know, though. I don't know. I still die even if I go to the closet. It doesn't make sense. I'm telling you, with the different... If there's no exclamation mark, you're dead. You can't do anything about it. It's almost like you need the exclamation mark. I just don't know. Because I've tried not closing the window when there's no exclamation mark. I've tried closing the window without the exclamation mark. It's impossible. There's just no way. This game's impossible. There's no way. There's no way I'm missing anything. It's simple. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed anyway, seeing my suffering. If you did, stick around for more, and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.